In this segment, we'll talk about can we divide two matrices. Let's suppose somebody says, hey, A times B is equal to C. So let's suppose A times B is defined where the number of columns of A is same as the number of rows of B, and then A times B is defined. So it'll be tempting to say, hey, oh, you know, B is C divided by A. But we don't define a matrix division like that when we are talking about matrices. So what do we do? Is there something which is equivalent to dividing two matrices? Yes, there is. Let's suppose if you have numbers, we're talking about scalars now. If you have real numbers A divided by B, you can very well see that A divided by B can be also written as A times B inverse. So you can take a number A divided by B, and if you want to find A times B, it can be relegated into a multiplication of two numbers where you're multiplying A times the inverse of B. And of course, there has to be some mechanism of finding this inverse of B to be able to change this division into multiplication. But that's the point right here that, hey, there are similar effort here for matrices. So in a matrix, what we do is, in matrices, what we do is say that if A B, is a n by n matrix. So let me say if A is an n by n matrix. If A is an n by n matrix, then B, which is again an n by n matrix, is the inverse of A. So we are now talking about how we define the inverse of a matrix. Now you're already finding out that, hey, we are limiting our definition of the inverse of a matrix by that it is limited only to square matrices. So if A is an n by n matrix, a square matrix, then the B is the inverse of A if A times B is equal to the identity matrix. So that's all you have to do. So if A is an n by n matrix, is a square matrix, then you are able to find another matrix B. We can call it the inverse of the matrix A if your A times B is called the identity matrix. Now keep in mind that every square matrix, the first thing which we have to realize is that only for square matrices does the inverse exist, and the inverse does not exist for every square matrix. We'll see that later, that whenever somebody gives you a square matrix, you won't be able to every time find another square matrix by which when you multiply A by B that you get the identity matrix. So that's the definition of the inverse of the matrix. So we also are able to say that, hey, if A times B, A and B are both square matrices, and you find out, hey, this is called the identity matrix, then B times A automatically will be also equal to the identity matrix. Many times people think that, hey, in order to show that one matrix is A is B is inverse of A, we have to show that A times B is I and B times A is I. No, that's not true. If A times B turns out to be I, then automatically B times A will be also equal to I. So in order to show that one matrix is inverse of the other, either you can multiply the two matrices in either fashion, either by B times A or A times B. If you get the identity matrix, then they are inverse of each other. So this also makes you believe, leads you to understand that if B is inverse of A, then A has to be the inverse of B. If A inverse exists, we call A to be invertible or non-singular. So if A inverse exists, then A is considered, is called to be invertible or non-singular. If A inverse does not exist, then A is considered to be singular, not invertible, or singular. So these are some words which are, or some phrases which are used about inverse of matrices and things like that. So the bottom line is that we are not able to divide two matrices. It's not defined. but we can always find the inverse of a matrix. The first thing about finding the inverse of a matrix, it has to be square, and then that inverse has to exist. And how do we figure out whether what it means to find the inverse of a matrix is that the multiplication of the two matrices has to be the identity matrix, that if A is inverse of B or B is inverse of A, either this has to be true or this has to be true, or if this is true then you'll find this to be true, if this is true then this will be true, and that's how you are able to establish whether one matrix is inverse is the inverse of the other. That's the end of this segment.